Hey guys. So, I've just seen the new Rogue One. I literally just got home from the cinemas. I am amazed and sad at the same time. I want to tell a little bit. It's a spoiler free. I'm not gonna spoil anything, don't worry. So there's a lot of impressions, a lot of characters introduced, a lot of old ones coming back. I don't even know what to say. It's extremely overwhelming and at the same time long overdue. There is a reason why it is the most anticipated movie of this year, and it deserves that qualification. It is an amazing movie. It is different from every other Star Wars movie because it is a spin-off. It is a Star Wars story. It is not one of the Star Wars movies, so it is different, which is completely fair. The music you can feel is different. The introduction in the movie is different. Some of the filming you can feel is different. But overall, absolutely beautiful, an amazing experience, and something everyone should go watch. No matter if you are an old school nostalgic fan who just likes the original cast and how they were made, to the hardcore fans like me who just wants anything Star Wars, it will give you a little bit of everything. I recommend it very highly. It is a beautiful movie. It's also filled with sadness, which I will get into. So it's just a little video about my experience with this movie, how I felt it, and I am amazed, completely amazed, and it is, I've been waiting for it for so long, and now it's finally here, and I've watched it tonight, but I'm going to be watching again on Saturday, and I would recommend everyone to go watch it. Thank you all for listening to my little experience here. So remember to subscribe, leave a like, follow me on Twitch, that's where I'm most. And I look forward to seeing your opinion when you see the movie. What you feel about it. Have a great one. May the Force be with you. Now, to the spoiler zone. For anyone who doesn't want any spoilers at all, stop the video now. Because now I will talk about some of the things that occurs. So, you get introduced to an unknown place, get introduced to the main character as a child, you get your catalyst already in the beginning for her, the loss of a parent, well, technically both of them. It starts off in an imperial prison, which most of you have already seen in the trailers and so on. Nothing extraordinary there. You get to see the planet Jeddah, which is apparently, according to this movie, the last remnant of any historical fact about the Jedi. Because that has the last known temple on this planet, where they are mining for certain crystals that they are using for a secret super weapon. They are dispatched to gain intel, of course. the character Jyn Erso is very reluctant to do anything. You can feel all the loss of her in her background, that you just, she doesn't want to collaborate at all, which is understandable when you get to know her character. What I like about the newer Star Wars movies is that you get introduced to a lot of new characters, which is amazing. You can always expand the universe of Star Wars, but sometimes you kind of miss some of the old characters that you know. You kind of miss some of the old races that you know, like a Twi'lek here or an Odlon there or something like that. You know, all characters that you know, and you don't see that much in the newer movies, which I find is a shame. However, there is a surprise on Jedi. I do not want to tell who it is, but it's a surprise of a couple of guys that you do see in one of the older movies, which was such a great, it was just a split second you see them and it's just, you recognize them instantly. It was amazing. However, there are small critiques, as there are good sides to it. And I'm sorry if I'm just rambling away here and you just listen to me talk and it doesn't make a lot of sense, and yeah, so sorry for that. But you meet some of the old characters which they have CGI'd, which is unbelievable, and it's so perfectly made. You can see it a little bit that it's CGI, but overall it's really beautifully made, and the voice acting for it as well is unbelievable. I am gonna spoil a little bit, because there are a lot of, it is right before episode 4, so a lot of the characters you know from episode 4 make an appearance, including a certain Moff, including a Dark Lord that you know, that everyone is expecting, of course, including some politicians that you know from older. But then I have to critique the way they made Darth Vader. I know there's probably there is probably an explanation to it, but the neck on his mask is too big, so it sticks out too much. I might be a little bit of a fiddle faddle with those kind of details, but it doesn't feel right. His cape goes all the way in here instead of out here and spreads down over his body. The little silver chain that's usually there to keep it together was not there. However, they do have James Earl Jones, which of course makes up for it. But it's just those small things I was a little bit disappointed about. When the movie stopped, I was in awe and I was in amazement of how brilliant I think this movie is, despite of minor flaws here and there. But most of all, I felt a lot of sadness. This movie, even though it shows the spark of hope, it shows that rebellion are building hope and all of that, and that's perfectly fine. It also showed the downsides. It showed the Empire from its very worst side in a lot of different ways. It also showed actually the rebellion from its worst side, from a political side. And I sat there, and then, when the music started for the curtain fall and everything, I just sat with the feeling of sadness in a way, because a lot of people die. You know, you heard the story, a lot of Bothans had to die to get this intel and so on and so on. You hear that in the old movies, how a lot of intel they gain is with a great sacrifice. This movie chose to sacrifice. And I was sad. I was, in the same time as I was amazed. I do not want anyone to feel discouraged to go watch it because it is an amazing movie. But if you do not sit with a kind of sadness afterwards, then I think something is wrong. I've been ranting on for about 10 minutes, I'm sorry about that. Thank you all for listening to my little experience here. So, remember to subscribe, leave a like, follow me on Twitch, that's where I'm most. And I look forward to seeing your opinion when you see the movie. What you feel about it. Have a great one. May the Force be with you.